Welcome to the class, students. Today we are recalling the next concept in analysis of univariate data, that is coefficient of quartile deviation and its coefficient. And one more concept is how to solve quartile deviation for open end classes and inclusive case of class intervals. Okay, let us solve some problems on this. So take down the problem first. Calculate QD and its coefficient. This is the data they have given actually. See, this class interval is not continuous. We have to make this continuous, then we have to go for the procedure. Let me write first the class interval. The new class interval I am writing now. Okay. So our new class interval is, you know how to convert this inclusive into exclusive intervals. So we have to subtract 0.5 in the lower limit and we should add 0.5 to the upper limit. We should subtract 0.5 to the lower limit and we should add 0.5 to the upper limit. So that if I subtract here 20 minus 0.5, it is 19.5 and this is 29.5. Similarly, we should continue the procedure for all the intervals so that we can make this to continuous. Okay, so this is our new class interval. The next step is we have to find the LCF, that is lower cumulative frequency. We have to find out the LCF. So your N value, capital N value is 804. The total of this is 804. To find LCF, the first frequency will remain same, that is 144. For that 144, again we will add the next frequency, that is 182. It is 326. Next, again we are adding 326 to 306, it is 632, 632 plus 96, 728, 728 plus 42, 770, 770 plus 34, it is 804. So this total is 804 and here the n is 804, so it is correct. To find QD, the formula to find QD is, QD is equal to Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. Okay, to find QD, that is coefficient or deviation, quartile deviations, it is Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. To find out Q3, we have to first find out the observation, that is Q3 is 3 times N by 4. This is 3 into 804 divided by 4. So Q3 value is, it is 603 observation. 603 will comes in LCF, that is 632. So this class interval we have to consider for Q3. Okay. So the formula to find Q3 is L plus 3N by 4 minus CF divided by F into C. Okay. Next is, your CF means the previous cumulative frequency, F means corresponding cumulative frequency, sorry, call the corresponding frequency, L is the lower limit and C is width of the class interval. For this particular formula, the width of the class interval is 10. To find out the width of the class interval, you have to subtract lower limit and the upper limit so that we will get the width of the class interval. Now, find out the Q3 value. L is 39.5 plus 3 times n by 4, already we have calculated, it is 603. minus EF, that is previous one, 326. EF is the frequency corresponding to the same interval, that is 306. Width of the class interval, it is 10. So this is 39.5 plus 9.05. So our Q3 value is 48.55. So Q3 value is 48.55. Next, the same procedure we are following to find out Q1. Q1 is 1 into n by 4. This is 804 by 4. This is 201 observation. 201, that is 209, it comes in 326 in LCF. So I am blocking this one, okay? So that, again, I'll write the formula. Q1 is equal to L plus n by 4 minus EF by F into C. And this is, your L is, this class interval L, lower limit, it is 29.5 plus n by 4, already we have calculated, is 201. CF means previous one, that is 144. And the F is corresponding frequency, that is 182, into C is 10. This is 29.5 plus 3.13, and your Q1 value is 32.63. Okay, this is Q1 value is 32.63. After finding Q3 and Q1, substitute the values in the quartile deviation formula, that is Q3 minus Q1 divided by 2. This is Q3 is 48.55, Q1 is 32.63 divided by 2. So our QD value is 7.96. 7.96. Next, we have to find a coefficient of QD. So coefficient of QD, the formula is Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1, and this is 48.55 minus 32.63 divided by 48.55 plus 32.63. After the simplification, it is 0.196. This is coefficient of QD. This is coefficient of QD, that is 0.196. This is how we have to find for inclusive type of class intervals. Okay. Next, we'll move on to next problem. Calculate QD and its coefficient. So they have given the class interval. It is less than 340, 340 to 370, 370 to 400, 400 to 430, 430 and above. And frequencies 14, 62, 99, 18 and 7. And this total frequency n is equal to 200. Okay. See, this is the problem they have given, and here the last interval they have not mentioned because it is 430 and above. It's an open end classes. We don't have a particular number for this. So that for these type of class intervals or a data also, we can calculate the QD, okay? So here, first step is same, that is we have to find the LCF. That is LCF is 14, 76, 175, 193, 200, okay? Next step, since we are having open-end classes, the particular interval, whichever the interval we get, in that interval, the width of the class interval we have to consider, okay? So first is, I'll write the QD formula. QD is equal to Q3 minus Q1 by 2. So we have to find Q1 and Q3 values. So I'll find Q1, that is N by 4. It is 200 divided by 4. It is 50th observation. 50th observation comes in LCF, that is 76. So I am blocking this one. Okay, so formula is L plus N by 4 minus CF by F into C. In each and every problem, you have to write the formula. For each and every problem, you have to write the formula so that you will get practiced and it is easy to write. Okay, you will not forget the formula. And in particular problems, in all the problems, formula will also carry marks. Okay, so next is Q1. L is the lower limit, that is 340, plus N by 4, already we have calculated, it is 50. And CF will be the previous one, that is 14, divided by F, the corresponding frequency, that is 62. And width of the class interval, for this particular class, it is 340 to 370. So, width of this class interval is 30. So, this is 357.11. So, this is your, after simplification, the Q1 value is this. Next, you have to find out the Q3. Q3 is 3 times N by 4. It is 3 into 50. It is 150th observation. 150 will comes in 175. So, I am blocking this one again. Okay. So, next again, we have to write the formula. Q3 is L plus 3N by 4 minus CF by F into C. And this L is 370 plus 3N by 4 is 3N by 4. Already we have calculated is 150. CF will be the previous one, this one, that is 76. And the frequency will be the corresponding frequency, that is 99 into C. Again, for this class interval, the width of the class interval is 30. And here this is 370 plus 22.42. And Q3 value is 392.42. Next, find out QD and coefficient of QD. Okay, so I'll substitute the values. Q3 is 392.42 minus 357.11 divided by 2, and this is 17.505. This is your QD value. Next, coefficient of QD is Q3 minus Q1 divided by Q3 plus Q1, and again you have to substitute the values. It is 392.42 minus 357.11 divided by 392.42 plus 357.11. After the simplification, the coefficient of QD is 0.046. So, this is your coefficient of QD and this is QD value. This is how the procedure will continue and will do for all the QD problems. Okay. Next, let's move on to next topic in the partition values, that is mean deviations. Mean deviations using mean, median and mode. Let us solve the problems on all the three topics. Okay, mean deviation using mean, median and the mode. Okay, take down the problem. Calculate mean deviation. Calculate mean deviation. Mean deviation using, sorry, from mean, median and mode. So we have to calculate the mean deviation using these three averages. Let me write the problem first. It is class interval and the frequency. It is 2 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 8, 8 to 10, 10 to 12, 3, 5, 8, 4, 2, and total n value is 22. Let's solve first the mean deviation using mean value. To calculate the mean deviation using mean, first step is we have to find out the mean value. Before that, to find out the mean value, here to find mean, that is x bar, it is summation of fx divided by n. Here we don't have the x values since this is a class interval. So we have to find out the midpoint. That midpoint itself is the x value. So x is the midpoint. For this, the midpoint is 3, 5, 7, 9 and 11. Next, find out fx. Fx is 3 3s are 9, 5 5s are 25, 8 7s are 56, 4 9s are 36, 11 2s are 22. Take the sum of this, that is summation of fx is equal to 148. Next, find out mean value. This is 148 divided by 22. So x bar value is 6.72. 6.72. So next is, I'll write the mean deviation formula using mean. That is summation of f into mod x minus x bar divided by n. Here, since we are taking the modulus, because inside the modulus, all the negative values will become positive. Okay, that's why we will take the modulus. So we have to take the deviation of x value with the mean value. Then we have to multiply that with the frequencies. So first we will write x minus x bar. That is, with the modulus, I am taking x minus x bar modulus. X value is 3 and x bar value is 6.72. If you subtract the value, you will get the negative value. Because 3 minus 6.72 will be, you will get negative value. Inside the modulus, that negative value will also become positive. Okay, so I'll write the x minus x bar value, that is 3.72, 1.72, 0.27, 2.27, 4.27. Next, multiply this f frequency and this column, x minus x bar modulus. So frequency column and this column, we have to multiply and we have to write the values, that is 11.16, 8.6, 2.16, 9.08, 8.54. Take the summation of this. Summation of this is 39.54. Now you substitute this in the formula. Here this is summation of f mod x minus x bar is this value. Okay, I'll write here. This is summation of f into mod x minus x bar. This summation is this. So this is 39.54 and the n value is 22. So mean deviation using mean is 1.76. is 1.70. Along with this, let's find out coefficient also. Okay, coefficient of mean deviation using mean is mean deviation of x bar divided by x bar. So mean deviation of x bar is this is 1.79 and x bar value is 6.72, and this is 0.266. So this is the coefficient of mean deviation using mean value. Okay. For the same problem, let us solve using the median value. Okay. Next, using median, I am solving. To find out the median, first we want the LCF value. So I'll write the LCF 3, 3 plus 5, 8, 16, 20, 22. Next is, we have to find out median is n by 2 observation. This is n is equal to 22 by 2. It is 11th observation. So 11th will comes in the this one LCF, that is 16. So I am blocking this one. Now find out the median value. Median is L plus n by 2 minus CF by F into C. Your lower limit is 6. N by 2 is 11. CF will be the previous one, that is 8. F will be the corresponding one, that is also 8. And width of the class interval is 2. Now find out the median value. Here median is 6 plus 0.75. So median is 6.75. Okay. After finding the median, the next procedure is we have to find the midpoint to take the deviation, that is x. X is the midpoint because we have to take modulus of x minus x bar. So midpoint is very, very important. So I am writing the midpoint 7, 9 and 11. Again you have to type, sorry, x, not x minus x bar, it is x minus median value. Median value is 6.75. 3 minus 6.75 we have to take, so that the you will get the values. It is 3.75, 1.75, 0.25, 2.25, 4.25. Next, f into mod x minus median. F into mod, f is the frequencies. With this column, we have to multiply. It is 11.25, 8.75, 2, 9, 8.5. Now, you take the summation of this. Summation of f into mod x minus median is equal to 39.5. After this, the next is you have to write the formula to find mean deviation using median. It is summation of f into mod x minus x bar divided by n. So this summation value is 39.5, and n is equal to 22, and here this is 1.795. this is mean deviation using median. Okay, this is how we'll find the mean deviation using median value. And let's solve the same thing for the using mod. Let's solve that one, okay? For the same problem, to find out the mod value, we have to see the highest frequency in the frequency column. So highest frequency here in the frequency column, it is 8. So it is easy. It is, this is FM, F1 and F2. So let's find out the mod value Z, that is L plus F0 minus F1 divided by FM minus F1, 2FM minus F1 minus F2 into C. Here this is, L is a lower limit, it is 6 plus FM value is 8 minus F1 is 5, 2 into 8 minus 5 minus 4 into 2. So it is 6 plus 0.857, this is 6.857. So this is your mod value. So to find out the deviation, again we want the midpoint, that is X. So again, I am writing the midpoint. It is 3, 5, 7, 9 and 11. Next is x minus z. Take the modulus. So x minus z, we have to take the deviation of x, deviation with the mode value, calculated mode value, so that x minus mode with the modulus, it is 3.85, 1.85, 0.15. 2.15, 4.15, and next the we have to multiply this with the frequency, that is F into this column, it is 11.55, 9.25, 1.2, 8.6, 8.3, and this total summation of f into mod x minus z is equal to 38.9. Now you find out the mean deviation using model. This is summation of f into mod x minus z divided by n, and this is 38.9 by 22. This is 1.768 mean deviation using mode. Whatever the deviation you take, only there is a point difference in the mean deviation values. Okay, so this is how we'll solve the problems on this. And these type of problem you may get for 5 marks, any one of the method, not all the 3 methods, any one. It can be from mean or median or mode value. So it is a very, very important topic. Please follow this one. Okay, thank you.